I'm going to school for screenwriting, and I'm also TAing. And this girl had a brilliant thing on the adaptation of Pride and Prejudice with Bridget Jones' Diary, talking about the devolution from feminism 200 years ago, the Elizabeth Bennet character, to the Renee Zellweger character in Bridget Jones. Elizabeth Bennet was really smart. Renee Zellweger in Bridget Jones is like, I don't know what I'm bloody doing! Anyway, the Darcy character, when he confronts, I keep thinking of Kiera Knightly, even though I know there's more than that version of it. There's also the PBS version, but for you, I'm going to do Kiera Knightly here tonight. Because that's how talented I am. Like, Alex, how are you going to play a young, heroin-chic, brunette anorexic? That's a little redundant, isn't it? She's either heroin-chic or she... No. Yeah, anorexic's heroin. Okay, anyway. But yeah, I'm going to do all that for you. Because that's how talented I am. They laughed. The rest of you are like, yeah, I believe you. Anyway, so in the classic version, Darcy goes off on everything that's wrong with Elizabeth Bennet. And Kiera Knightly, playing the Elizabeth Bennet character the way it was originally written, goes off on him and says, Mr. Darcy, I'm so sorry that I've caused you so much pain. But you're the last man on earth I'd marry. Thank you, genius, right in front of you. Right here. And then Renee Zellweger character, when the Darcy character says to her, I know you're overweight, you're a smoker, you're inappropriate parties, you swear, you're not good at public speaking. But in spite of all of that, I like you. Just the way you are. I have to go now because I'm a barrister and I'm a snob and I have to... He has to say I'm a snob because I have to go now because I'm a barrister and I have to go hang out with this skinny, fabulous woman up here, but I like you just the way you are. And Bridget Jones's reaction to that is... Not that I'm showing you what I think of her and her character. They like me just the way I am. Not thinner. Not stopping smoking. Just the way I am. But I hate him. But I like him. Thank you very much. Okay.
Yeah.
So we've got the de-evolution of, like, there was more feminism in it 200 years ago. But in the modern day, Bridget Jones, and the person doing the presentation, described her as a woman who just believes that if she loses weight, she'll get the guy she really likes. And as a feminist, I felt like, oh God, I relate to this character. But I'm not supposed to admit that as a feminist. I'm supposed to say, that's atrocious! But he liked me just the way I am. I'm smitten. That's probably why it was such a hit. Anyway, so. Thank you. God bless you all. God bless you all, my dears. So I guess that is sort of the new feminism, is to be able to admit our insecurities and not put up a false bravado, still sticking up for what's right, and admitting that, yeah, we do need to be loved for exactly who we are in every phase of our development. I had Kazumi Kasano say to me, is that your real hair? Not the color, Kazumi. But she said, it looks like Barbie doll hair. And I said, yeah, I used to play Barbies. Maybe I have some of the effects of Barbie doll damage going on, right? Boobs that stick straight up with no nipples. Who can live up to that? No hips, legs that don't bend. Yeah, I was old school Barbies before they bend. Anyway. But, you know, it's the freedom I was taught in women's studies to be able to dress yourself up to the nines, wear makeup, or not. And for my show, I dress up, I have a good time. The rest of the week, I'm not. The rest of the week, I don't wear makeup. Yeah, when I'm in school, I'm very much the intellectual, take me seriously type. You know. And, but I, when I have a show on, it's great to have an excuse to dress up and, because I mean, let's face it, this outfit doesn't really make sense in any sort of work environment. Except for comedy. Right? As a comedian? Or a hooker, maybe? No, no. Anyway. No, I don't think I'd make it as a hooker. Because I'm just way too picky. You know, I'm like... I've been celibate, so how can I be a hooker if I'm celibate? What would that be like? It'd be like a guy coming up to me, offering me money for sex, and me saying, do you have the Lord? I find that's the best birth control ever, is just to start bringing up Jesus. Anyway, yeah, that's always good. The other thing is, there's still a difference, though, between men and women when it comes to sex. And some people don't think so, but I'm going to prove it here tonight. Here we go.
Okay.
Men! Yes! You know who you are! They will go to someone on a street corner they don't even know. Roll down the window. Offer her money. Just to touch it! You'd never see a woman go to a street corner. Roll down the window. Call out to some strange guy she doesn't know. How much? Just to touch it. If that actually started to happen, it would be like, I think you should pay me. Not quite the same thing. So anyway, just know, we're always worth more on the open market. So you should treat us with respect. We should treat you with respect. But it's not the same. Because a guy has sex, I'm done. Not that I've been with guys that are that bad in bed recently. But, but like, it's just pure pleasure for them. No risk, no gain. A woman, she has sex. You know what we're risking? We're risking 9 months of pain. Stretch marks. You think we might be a little more wary and careful about whether it happens or not, right? And then there's the biggest pain of all. What if he doesn't call? Right? There's this emotional pain. There's a time when I was younger where I tried to sleep around like a guy, you know, we're just animals, it's just psychological shame put on me by this, you know, patriarchal religious society. I just want to have my fun. And I forgot, even with birth control, even with, you know, no fear of pregnancy, I'm a woman. I have feelings. I get attached. Even when I don't like a guy. Afterwards, after the oxytocin, I'm like, I can love him. Anyway, so I learned to be careful with my body. It's precious. We're all precious, though. Men mean a lot, too, though, because... once you start having really good sex with someone, have you noticed that sometimes it's the woman that wants it more than the man? Okay, only the women are snickering at that. They're kind of like, what? If you're at the Funny Family Show, you're going to learn about sex. You're going to be the best in bed with any woman from this point forward. Because there's guys where they're like, you know, she broke up with me. I don't know why. We were together 2 years. I'll tell you why. A month. Before the last part of you guys being together is the day you stop going down on her before intercourse. When you stop giving her pleasure, she doesn't want to have sex with you anymore. Okay, only Erica. Only Erica, freaking only the sister in the room gets that. We know a little more about sex. Us white people who are fake blondes and look a little hoary, like we've had some experiences in our life. And the sister are the only ones that know what we're really pissed off about. Because in polite white girl culture, okay? Okay, right? So girls are laughing at themselves, and you know what I'm talking about too, okay? The thing is, women won't admit that's what's really bugging them, right? I'm really angry, I don't know why. The energy's wrong. That's it. That's why we have to break up. We're not gonna say, it's because you're not making me come. And when I don't come, I can't sleep. And when I can't sleep, I like to argue because I can't sleep because I'm not getting my endorphins back. And if I don't argue, what do? I go eat pasta I'm not really hungry for. And then I get fat and then I'm pissed. So I subvert it all into, oh, it must be a weight problem. No, it's because I'm not coming. So if you keep your woman coming, she'll keep you coming. Yeah, the married woman, she's getting it. She's getting it. And that's what's called true love.
Right.
You never have to get a divorce. If you're taking care of your woman, she will take care of you. But the second you put your orgasm first, oh, we get so mad, don't we? Anyway, okay, only the sister, now the Asian woman who's married, the girl who has a boyfriend, obviously you guys have a good relationship because you can laugh, okay? And, but the other white people don't really get it. Some of the maybe more experienced white women get it, and the white guy's finally getting it. All right, very good. The black guy's like, I don't know what you all are talking about. Because you're great in bed, you've never had this problem. Anyway, so that's what it translates to when a woman says, it's the energy. Anyway, that's what it is. It's me, it's not you. No, it's you. Anyway.